His lawmakers and legal experts dismissed the call of former President Rodrigo Duterte for the creation of a Mindanao Republic, but a signature campaign is already being planned to seek support for the island's secession. Adrian Ayalin reports.
It's the strongest painkiller.
Amid political bickering between President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and former President Rodrigo Duterte, talks of Mindanao seceding from the rest of the country is being revived. After publicly opposing moves to amend the constitution through a people's initiative, the former president said counter moves to gather signatures for the secession of Mindanao is also ongoing.
The only reason na bakit kami talagang disappointed is ang pera ng bayan, inuubos kung anong pinaggagawa. But of course, kung mag-separate independent to, at magpuntahan lahat dito ang Pilipino, then it's gonna be a big problem. So, for us on its growing years, you have to restrict. But you can come. Mga taga Luzon, Visaya, we will not deny you.
The former president said he has tasked former House Speaker and now Davao del Norte Representative Pantaleon Alvarez to lead the campaign for the secession of Mindanao.
Walang gulo, definitely. Gagawin namin, kailangan kahit na mahirap gawin yung ikutan yung buong Mindanao para ipaliwanag sa lahat ng mga taga Mindanao kung bakit namin ginagawa ito.
But according to some law professors, secession of any part of the country is against the Constitution.
Legally, we cannot declare an area of the Philippines separate from the Republic of the Philippines. So yan is a crime, no, against public order.
Very remote, talagang exceptional, kailangan pahintulutan ng bansa na may humiwalay sa kanya bago siya maging posible. Hindi siya legally possible under the Philippine Constitution.
Another question arises, did the former president commit sedition or rebellion because of his secession statement?
Technical kasi ang definition ng sedition sa revised penal code, ano siya, kailangan may force, intimidation, yung ganung klase ng level ng activity. Kung ang level lang naman ng activity dito ay pagngalap ng signatures, hindi siya mag-arise to that level.
He keeps on reiterating his call for secession and there are actually movements that would actively seek the separation of Mindanao from the Philippines, I think it's already a crime.
Some lawmakers from Mindanao registered their opposition to the proposal.
With due respect to the former president, I think right now the last thing that we want is na magkagulo-gulo, magkawatak-watak ang ating bansa.
But at least one Mindanaoan lawmaker is keeping an open mind.
Hindi madaling gawin yan, ano, yung secession ng island of Mindanao. But it's also probably worth it to look into it, no? Pag-aralan, tingnan natin kung ano ba yung benepisyo ng mga Mindanaoan dito.
Commission on Elections Chairperson George Garcia refused to comment on the gathering of signatures for the secession of Mindanao in the same way as signatures are gathered for charter change.
Sa bandang huli po kasi ang susundin nating lahat, kahit ang COMELEC, ay ang ating Philippine Constitution. And therefore, lahat ng mga pagbabago sa Philippine Constitution ay kinakailangang dumaan sa proseso.
The Marcos administration, meantime, has yet to comment on the proposal of former President Duterte for a separate Mindanao. Adrian Ayalin, ABS-CBN News.
Well, let's get another perspective on this proposal to create a Mindanao Republic. Joining us now is the Deputy Parliament Speaker of the Bangsamoro Transition Authority, Omar Yasser Sema. BTA Deputy Parliament Speaker Sema, magandang hapon po. Thank you for joining us today and welcome to the program.
Yeah, magandang hapon, Katrina, and assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh.
Yeah, Deputy Speaker, it's Carmina, and you're live on AMC.
Hi, Carmina. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Okay. Not a problem. But this, what we're going to talk about, might be a problem. But this is nothing new. You've got MNLF in the past, MILF in the past, you've got the Kanoy Initiative in the past. But what are your thoughts that there is this renewed call for the secession of Mindanao coming from a former president? Go ahead, po.
Yeah, I think from the context of the Bangsamoro or the BARM, we should look at how the leadership of the BARM itself, the MILF and then the MNLF, how would they look into it? And we would clearly see and easily see that both fronts have already abandoned their call for secession. And in fact, the MILF have downgraded their call for the establishment of an Islamic State to meaningful and genuine self-governance. And currently, we can say that both fronts are doing well in the Bangsamoro transition process. And the situation does not allow us, you know, it's not even, there's no basis to go back to the call for secession. But nonetheless, that has been there since it was started by the Moro National Liberation Front in the 70s, mm-hmm. though they abandoned it in 1976 and completely declared against it in 1996 through the signing of the 1996 Final Peace Agreement.
Correct.
And the Moro Islamic Liberation Front had already entered into the Comprehensive Agreement and the Bangsamoro, and where both fronts are enjoying, you know, the limited self-governance. Both fronts and the people are enjoying the limited self-governance, and we're trying to make the most out of it. In fact, we are almost complete in our mandate here to prepare the region for the first regular parliamentary elections in 2025.
So exactly the point. When you lay it out as such, and then you have this renewed call for the secession of Mindanao, do you take it to mean that these people who are pushing for the secession of Mindanao this time around are thinking that the BARM may have been a failed experiment?
I have not heard that in the current discussion. Because these are all linked into the call for charter change. But then again, there are things that I think are being looked upon. Beyond right now, yung hindi nakikita, no? What I'm telling, and this has been what I'm telling to a lot of people here, that in fact there is now an opportunity here in the call for charter change to entrench the Bangsamoro in the 1987 Constitution, and that is part of the Comprehensive Agreement of the Bangsamoro. And as far as the Moro National Liberation Front is concerned, we have agreed to join in this transition government because we believe that the CAB can implement the 1976 Tripoli Agreement and the 1996 Final Peace Agreement. So, and we fully agree, we fully support that provision in the Comprehensive Agreement of the Bangsamoro to entrench the Bangsamoro in the 1987
So it's exactly the opposite of what former Speaker Alvarez and former President Duterte want to happen. You see charter change as an opportunity to entrench the Bangsamoro. This is what they're saying. I talked to former Speaker Alvarez yesterday. He's not even respecting the Constitution anymore. In so many words, he's saying, ayaw na nga namin yung Constitution eh. Ito na nga ang gusto namin eh. And they say, at least according to the former Speaker, that they speak for the Mindanaoans. Do you think that's true?
I think at some point they can speak on some issues for the Mindanaoans, like, of course, equitable share in the economy, of course. That's one point that they can speak for the Mindanaoans, and of course on policy decisions that the Mindanaoans should also be heard, you know. But as far as we can see, as we are now given the opportunity to participate in the national policy making, no? The Bangsamoro, nakikita natin na hindi talaga maganda yung pinag-uusapan yung secession ngayon, considering that of the external threats that we are facing right now. China is threatening our our cohesiveness. Maraming nakukuha sa ating mga territory being now identified with China. I think that should be taken into consideration in coming up with coming out with such statements as secession. But then again, we believe that the former president and Speaker Alvarez have at some point in their careers, you know, they have walked the talk. Alam din nila may problema yung constitution. Alam din nila may problema yung government system natin. That's why they introduced yung federalism idea during their terms, and they even won on the basis of those campaign slogans, no? And I think secession is not the solution to our current problems right now.
You know, Attorney Sam, I'm glad that you mentioned what's happening in the West Philippine Sea. Speaking to the former Speaker Alvarez yesterday, that's exactly what he mentioned. Ang sabi po niya, pag pinag-uusapan yung West Philippine Sea, nadadamay pati ang Mindanao. Ayaw daw po niyang mangyari yun. Kaya daw po panahon na para maging independent ang Mindanao. Dahil nasasabit daw ang Mindanao sa mga isyung wala naman daw po silang kinalaman.
I think medyo may flaw doon sa statement ni Speaker Alvarez. Hindi ho buong Mindanao ang nadadamay doon sa issue ng West Philippine Sea. I think it's only Sulu and its islands, no, because some part of the West Philippine Sea practically belong to the Sulu Sultanate, no? That should be the context there.
Oo, kasi ang sinasabi
it's
niya
not
po,
the entire Mindanao.
Yeah, ang sinasabi po niya kahapon dun sa pag-uusap namin, Attorney Sema, pag halimbawa daw po nagkagulo, hunger will be 10 times more. Yun daw po ang iniiwasan niya. And not so much what's happening in the Sulu Sea, but really, if the whole nation gets to be involved, Mindanao will get involved. At that, yun po ang kanyang iniiwasan. Do you think that's fair reason? Go ahead.
No, I think wala naman dapat gulo dito eh. And we're looking at the constitutional remedies, no? And kung may problema naman ho yata sa how the system works, we need to go back to the constitution, and there are processes there that can be availed of to settle all our problems. And in fact, charter change nga ho, is a remedy to solve our problems, and it's not necessarily secession. There are government systems that could be appropriate for us. For instance, natinatabi natin noon they advocated for federalism. That's a solution to the problem. And hindi ho kailangan ang gulo dito. And it can be all our leaders should talk about it and settle this one and for all in a peaceful manner. And you know, lahat naman ho na pag-uusapan dito, they are all mature and intelligent people na alam din nila yung ginagawa nila, alam din nila yung mga proseso na nakasaad sa ligang batas.
And do you think this has a possibility of, you know, snowballing into a scenario where and it will be Mindanaoan against Mindanaoan? Meron silang isinusulong, ganito ang gusto nilang mangyari, kayo naman sa BARM, klaro sa inyo kung ano ang dapat niyong gawin, kung bakit nandiyan kayo sa posisyon ngayon. Do you think that it will ever come to that?
I don't think so, because sa amin naman ho, is naiintindihan din ho namin saan ang gagaling yung sentimento ng dating Pangulo, and we have to respect that. But then again, the cooler heads should come and aid in the discussion. Look at the whole discussion of charter change as an opportunity to find ways to improve our systems. No, there are alam natin malaki kasi yung impact din ng charter change. Tama yung sinasabi ng iba. It could lead to extension of terms of office, etc. But then again, these may be some of the sacrifices. But I'm speaking here from the perspective of the Bangsamoro being entrenched in the 1987 constitution, no? Hindi ho lumalabas yan sa usapin ng charter change.
Yeah, exactly.
They are only talking about economic provisions of the constitution. Even the COMELEC, they know that our election system is obsolete, no? They also need to improve the Omnibus Election Code. But then again, before they do that, there should be some changes in the 1987 Constitution. Alam ho nila yan. Mm-hmm. So these are not being included in the discussion. Mm-hmm. I believe that from the perspective of the President, kung sinasaad niya, na, kung sinasabi ho siguro niya, ang dami natin kailangan gawin, dahil hindi ho magkakaroon, kunyari, ng exit agreement with the MILF, kailangan natin ipag-usapan yung entrenchment of the Bangsamoro. And the entrenchment of the Bangsamoro deals and it can be dealt with in the amendment of the 1987 Constitution.
Let's get into that. Because tama po kayo nung sinabi niyong hindi yan ang napag-uusapan. Naging, borrowing the President's words now, he's saying that this whole issue of charter change, people's initiative, it has become so political. But let's go to the substantive issues now. When you talk about it, the opportunity of Mindanao getting entrenched in the 1987 Constitution, how exactly, how will this look like? Go ahead, Paul.
Yes, of course, currently the 1987 Constitution provides for autonomy in the autonomous region in Muslim Mindanao, and this has been one of the bottlenecks in the passage of Republic Act 11054. Mm-hmm. But then again, the President then Duterte found ways to make sure that the Bangsamoro organic law would be passed by Congress, mm-hmm. despite the very limited powers allotted for autonomy in the 1987 Constitution. That's why nga ho, merong petition sa Bangsamoro Organic Law. Even now, may petition na ho sa Bangsamoro Electoral Code because nakikita nila may mga unconstitutional provisions. I mean, sort of unconstitutional provisions. But then again, if we entrench the Bangsamoro, particularly those agreed upon in the comprehensive agreement of the Bangsamoro, these could all once and for all settle the issues on constitutionality of the BOL, the Bangsamoro Electoral Code, which the DTA has passed. And I think yun lang ho, mababago lang ho yung provision ng autonomous region dun sa 1987 Constitution, and it will not have an impact on the entirety of the 1987 Constitution.
Attorney Sama, what do Mindanaoans want at this point? And what are your fears? Go ahead.
Yeah, what the Mindanaoans, I believe I can speak for everybody here. So, ang gusto lang mano natin is an equitable share in the economy of the Republic of the Philippines. Karamihan mo sa Mindanao talaga ay mahihirap, no? Rebellion still persists here from the National Democratic Front or the New People's Army, nandiyan pa rin sila. And there are still sinasabi natin yung mga hindi satisfied sa the peace process sa Bangsamoro, like the Bangsamoro Islamic Freedom Movement, etc. may mga extremists pa rin ho. But all of these can be erased, mawawala ho ito lahat kung kagaya sa experience ng Bangsamoro, kung itong self-governance namin mag-improve pa, ma-strengthen. And of course, yung sa equitable share in the economy. And of course, gusto lang man taga Mindanao marinig yung boses nila in terms of national policies.
Mm. At hindi secession ang paraan dito. Kasi pag halimbawa,
hindi ho secession.
Pag nangyari po yun, anong mangyayari sa BARM?
Yeah, we will still be caught in the crossfire, you know. Probably, we can still be a self-governing region, assuming magse-separate ang Mindanao, but we would not know the real situation if that happened.
So parang yung pinaghirapan nitong mga nakaraang dekada, mawawala ng parang pula, ganun ho ba?
That could be a possible scenario, you know, baka pwedeng mawala ng parang pula. But we're still hoping na yung mga leaders natin mag-uusap and try to look from the perspective of the Bangsamoro na yung charter change is an opportunity for us to make the necessary adjustments in the 1987 Constitution as far as our political arrangement is concerned. If they feel na yung presidential system no longer works, then maybe may parliamentary system or a federal system. Of course, yung economic provisions, we need to improve that kasi marami nagsasabi, obsolete na daw yung economic provisions ng 1987 Constitution. But then again, the solution is not secession. Hindi ho yun ang solution sa mga problema natin.
Attorney Omar Yasser Sema, he is the Bang Samora Transition Authority Deputy Parliament Speaker. He just joined us this noon, giving us his insights. Maraming salamat po. We appreciate all the things that you said today. Thank you.
Much appreciated, Carmina, and thank you for the opportunity.
Ingat po lagi. You.